Hello, my lovely atoms. A very, very warm welcome to all of you. I hope you all are doing absolutely awesome. And I hope you are going to have a great year this time. And the situation of Corona should be over soon. Let's pray for the same and a very happy new year. I know a bit late, but better late than never. It's just a start of the new year. My name is Anubha Gaur, your chemistry master teacher at Vedantu. And what are we going to do today, everyone? This is a VIP series. I hope you know the name itself is telling you so many things. Very important series. But why it's so important? Because we are going to discuss previous year very important questions along with some sample paper questions. So that, you know, that exam is already postponed by 6th May. You have plenty of time. So even if you're starting afresh and you're like, ma'am, I need to revise everything from the very start. This is a high time. And by following VIP series after your Umang series and one shot video, that's going to help you a lot for your revision purpose. So are you all super ready to have the session of acids, bases and salts? That is session number 3 with your Anubha ma'am. And in this session, we are going to talk about the salts part and its application and uses part. That means we already talked about acids and bases, their chemical properties and pH balancing and all. So please see those two videos also. If you're new, don't forget to subscribe to the channel for all the upcoming updates so that you'll never miss any session. And don't forget to like the video and share it among your friends to tell that how lovely this platform is going to be for them and going to be very informative one. Okay, so your AG ma'am is here to have this session, but I thought let's start the session this time with a bit fun. How come? Okay, I have something for you. And I think most of you can relate to it, huh? The feeling that we get when we feel a bit special in the class. So it's like teacher-student thing. How you feel when the teacher uses your name in an example? Sometimes I do that as well, that, you know, I take some of the examples, suppose Indira, suppose Ankan. So my students are like at the same time, oh, stop it, ma'am. What are you doing? It's okay. It's okay. So do let me know, can you relate to the same and having a special smile on your face and, you know, that kind of a situation when you don't know how to react, like, oh, stop it, ma'am. Okay, yeah, I know. Okay, so that is it. A bit fun. Do let me know in the comment section whether you faced it at any moment of time in your school or any platform. And with the Josh and energy, please stay till the end. That's going to be an important session. Let's have the very first question. The question that came to your 2015. As I said, all the questions are going to be very important. And some are going to be very easy, like we are going to discuss a variety of questions, especially the ones that comes from the chemical reaction part, like this is giving that and that is giving that and complete all of that XYZ product or ABC product. Okay, so stay tuned. The very first question is, which of the following salts does not contain water of crystallization? I hope you remember what is water of crystallization. Some water molecule that is attached to a proper molecule which is giving a crystalline structure to it and sometime color also. And to mention those water molecule, we use dot. It's like physically attached to my molecule. So when I talk about, suppose, blue vitriol, that is copper sulfate with 5 molecule of water. This is water of crystallization. I have to show it by showing that dot, that point. And when I talk about washing soda, okay, let's have this competition. Who will give answer faster than me? You please keep on typing your answer in the comment section, in the chat box. If you are seeing the video, like not being premiered, you can always give answer in the comment section also. And I'll see and try to reply at times, okay? Whenever ma'am finds any time, I see your comments and try to reply as well, yeah? So see that for the sake of convenience, I wrote all the formula and now it became super, super visible. Only baking soda here is the one that's not using any water of crystallization. Means that's not having that crystalline kind of appearance and not color also. Baking soda is the answer because rest molecules are the one that is carrying some water molecule. Super easy. Yeah. Okay, and that's what it is. You can download the file because all the proper answers are written with all the informations given. Yes, So baking soda is the answer. Let's move to the question number 2. And that came in year 2019. That's very good. And that's easy too, based on salt, because we are discussing salts and some of the very important salts, how to prepare it and all. Sodium carbonate is a basic salt because it is a salt of. Okay, I told in my Umang sessions that my salts are something that is made up of acid and base and a product of neutralization reaction. So how come we judge that the given salt is acidic, basic or neutral? I am going to give you a very short trick. And what exactly is this? You know that salt is made up of a base part and an acid part. And you know that the first substance is positive and the next one is negative. That's how you get your ionic compound. Try to add OH in this one and H in this one. Because positive, so add hydroxyl in that. And whatever negative, add H positive in that. You will get your respective acid and base. So we have 2 Na, so I'll take 2 OH. I'm going to get 2 molecule of NaOH. So 2 OH, so definitely 2 H also, like 2 molecule of water I have taken. And 2 H with CO3, that's H2CO3. I hope you understood it. And I got my respective acid and base by taking my salt and mixing water into the same. So it's like a reverse reaction. Salt water will give my acid and base back. And you know that sodium hydroxide is a pretty strong base. Yes or no? Yes. And carbonic acid is the one that we use in soft drink also. That's a weak acid. Okay. So what will be the answer here? Weak acid and strong base. That's why that's a basic salt. And this information though is giving the sufficient data, but I told you like a proper approach for the same. So you can follow anything. Basic means strong base is used for the same, or I'll tell you the, or I already told you the entire solution how to do that. So just see strong base and weak acid. D is the answer. I hope you got it. Easy peasy. I do think so, but it's all about you. You have to revise it properly and can follow, as I said, Umang videos and one shot videos also. Okay, let's have the question number 3 that came to the year 2017. And the question is, one of the constituents of baking powder is sodium hydrogen carbonate. Okay, baking powder is basically a mixture of my baking soda, which is this. And we need to tell the other component, that's basically an edible acid. And you know that organic acids are edible in nature. We eat in our day-to-day life as well, like tomatoes, my oranges, my lemon, etc., etc. So one of the organic acid that's used is either tartaric acid, citric acid, because citrus fruits are the one that will give my pleasant taste only, and we can have that. And the very famous one that we use for the preparation of baking powder is tartaric acid, and you can easily get it in grocery stores also, but better to get the baking powder bottle itself. Okay, so that's tartaric acid, weak organic acid. Do let me know, I have a question for you, that in which of the fruit you can find tartaric acid. Okay, so baking soda mixed with tartaric acid is the one they react to give a salt, and that is like sodium tartarate. The salt is basically a neutralized product and not having any bitter taste, so it won't make the taste of your food bitter at all. So you have to mix this organic acid for the same. So that's easy question, answer is B. I hope you know it, I hope you got it. Yes, do let me know. Okay, now we have certain questions also, like 2 marker, 3 markers also. Year 2015 had this question, how would you distinguish between baking powder and washing soda by heating? Okay, first of all, you should know the formula. This is my baking powder, which is baking soda mixed with an organic acid. Okay, when I talk about washing soda, that's sodium carbonate with the 10 molecule of water, decahydrate, sodium carbonate decahydrate. Let me just tell you, when I talk about baking powder, I'm properly talking about here baking soda only, because we just want to heat it and it's just a mixture. So what will happen when you heat the mixture, the sodium hydrogen carbonate, whenever we heat it, is the one that is going to evolve a gas. The purpose to have this question is to differentiate between the two. So when you heat it, either you heat it with organic acid, suppose we are taking tartaric acid. So what are the products that we are going to achieve? Sodium tartarate as the salt, okay, because this sodium part will react with the negative part of the acid to give sodium tartarate. Water along with CO2 gas. This is a reaction which is very common, and I taught in the very first session also of acid, bases and salts, that whenever metal carbonate and bicarbonate react with acid, we get salt, water and CO2. So I got a salt, I got water and I got a gas CO2. So this is the very first point you have to mention, that when you heat baking powder, these are the product and we are going to get CO2 gas, and we can detect it also, that can turn lime water milky, and when you pass through lime water, it gives calcium carbonate precipitate as well. But when you take washing soda, this is your washing soda, what will happen when you heat it? It's pretty obvious. You can see there are some water molecule which is a part of the structure. So when you heat it, that will be evaporated. So you are going to left with what? My just sodium carbonate, which is called as soda ash, not having any crystalline appearance, having a powdery dull appearance over there. So there is no like a gas formation over there, and that's pretty obvious. So that's what you need to mention. First, you write about baking soda, that when you heat it, a gas is released that can turn lime water milky, that can extinguish a burning matchstick. But when I talk about washing soda, some water molecule which is physically attached to it will evaporate and you're left with soda ash. Yeah, that's what it is. I hope that's like pretty clear over there. Now, that's called an interesting question that appeared in 2010, 2015 and 2018. So salt part is quite important, okay? I'm trying to match it with just the arrow, and you can try to do the same. Just take a pencil and try to match like that way, and then see the option. Because if you directly look for the option, you might feel confused a bit and ended up having any wrong answer. Okay, so we'll not do that. We'll try to match column A with the column B. And bleaching powder, we need to see where we use it. Same with baking soda, washing soda and sodium chloride. Let's do that. You know that bleaching powder, the name is giving answer, used for the bleaching purpose. Means for the decolorization of your cloth. Cotton industry, wood pulp industry to make paper and all. Yeah. Baking soda, very good. It's like a home remedy when you don't have any Eno, Jellicle and all. You can take baking soda, put it in water and can have it. That can relieve acidity because it will react with the excess of acid as its base to neutralize that acid. Yeah? Okay. Washing soda is the one that's used for the preparation of glass. Now that's string. Yeah. Because this part of washing soda, sodium carbonate, is the one that we use for the formation of borax, and borax is one of the main component with the help of which we can make the glass. Do let me know in the comment section the formula of borax also. Okay, now sodium chloride is the one that we can prepare hydrogen and chlorine, and the process for the same is chloralkali process. If you remember, when you take the brine solution of sodium chloride with water, saturated solution of sodium chloride in water, and pass electricity, you will get NaOH, you will get hydrogen gas and chlorine gas. So now see which option could be correct. A should be the attached to the third one and B to the fourth one. A 3, fourth B, first C should connect to the first one and D should connect to the second one. Yeah, so I got the answer. I hope my answer and your answer is matching. Because I'm telling you the same thing, that have a notebook and a pen, solve it with me and match your answer. How to write it, just listen to all the steps also. Okay, so answer here is C. Okay, so students, before moving ahead, just a small information that how Vedantu can help you to score very good marks and can boost your score. Still, you have opportunity. Don't feel that you are pretty late. You're not, because as you know, exams have been postponed. You have plenty of time to even start from today. Don't miss it. Come to Vedantu platform. That's just the YouTube platform. We have classes at its own platform. unlimited live classes you will be able to access and going to have an amazing experience. Can have high level quizzes because we believe in active participation so that you'll participate and can submit your response and can tell us that yeah, I got it. Otherwise, we can repeat and can understand accordingly. We'll get everything with the help of data. And you can have a very healthy competition with the students throughout the world and can have a very good competition. And that's very fun too. Even by any mistake, you miss a session, you can see the session n number of times in a way of replay and can submit your answer at that moment of time also. You can have live quizzes. You can have leaderboard, your name in the leaderboard in the replay too. Isn't it like so amazing? You will be able to download the notes of the master teachers as well, because we'll give feedback in each and every class so that with the most important question, you can have it. This is pretty important that it's not like you just listen to us. Quiz, active participation, your doubts will be answered with the help of master teachers and a team of class teachers too. So your doubts are important. No doubt is unanswered. Okay. 5,000 plus micro courses are there, which are chapter-based courses. You can revise any chapter, and special courses, special classes with most important question series and all can have it and revise each and everything till that there'll be no knowledge gap with the particular chapter. This is the best attraction right now. That's crash courses, because so many crash courses are going to start just because of the same reason. You have plenty of time and can revise each and every topic with us and definitely can boost your score by at least 15-20%. Okay, so for that, what you all have to do, Vedantu 19th English channel has pinned a message, means the very first message you will see by Vedantu only. There is a link for pro classes given. Click it, select CBSC 2021 as your target, CBSC 10th year class, and AGE English channel pro classes is your code to get and avail the discount. AGE Pro, for 1 month you will get a discount of 20%, and for 3 months you will get a discount of 33% on Vedantu MRP. And to be very honest, 2159 for a month, and if I calculate this, 1866 per month if you will apply the code, and you see the difference. Okay, and having just a session for as low as 11 to 9 rupees, as you have the opportunity to attend n number of sessions depending upon your way of handling and your growth. Okay, so you can choose accordingly. Okay, now let's have the next question, question number 6. As I told you, these kind of questions are very important where you just need to figure out A, B and C. So you need to put more attention on such questions. Year 2015 and 19, these question came. Salt A, commonly used in bakery products. Whenever I say bakery products, I feel like on a next level, because I am a big fan of, you know, all those bakery products, and I never miss this substance, particularly, you know, baking soda, a basic salt. So this should be pretty much clear. You have to pay attention on the uses part and all the name of the, you know, important salts. So bakery product, that salt must be sodium hydrogen carbonate, called as baking soda. On heating, get convert to a salt B. Yeah, and how we can confirm what will be the salt here? As I said, uses will be very much important. That salt is used for removal of permanent hardness of water, and you know that's nothing but a part of your washing soda, your sodium carbonate. So when you heat it, we can use the delta symbol. And apart from that, a gas is also released. So you know that when you take two molecules of the same, you will get B as sodium carbonate, yes, H2O, along with a gas, that's CO2, two molecule of CO2. So B is your washing soda, permanent hardness of water. We use it to remove permanent hardness of water. Gas is my carbon dioxide. And we can confirm it as well that the gas C, when passed through lime water, it turns milky, which is proving the point that's the CO2 gas only. And what you will get? Calcium carbonate, CaCO3, with water. So now I know ABC very clearly, and if such questions came, this is like a bonus for you. If you know the approach, you will get the full marks without even cutting half marks. So you can, you know, have these questions as your agenda, how to attempt that. And in the last, write also A is equal to this, B is equal to this, C is equal to this. And teacher will be like, yes, now you should get full marks. Okay. So come on, try to solve this question with me. Let's see who'll solve it faster and give all your response. What will be that XYZ and all. That question came in 2010, 16 and 18 too. That's like important one. In one of the industrial process of manufacture of NaOH, a gas X is formed as byproduct. Try to remember the reaction where you get sodium hydroxide alkali as a product along with a gas, an important gas, and how to detect the gas that react with lime water to give a substance Y, which is used as a bleaching agent. I think this clear the confusion that bleaching agent that we know in this chapter is calcium oxychloride. So here, can I figure it out that the gas is chlorine? Is there any confusion in the same? Because the gas must react with lime water to give CaOCl to calcium oxychloride. So how come chlorine came to the picture? Because that gas was chlorine. Now chloralkali. Now you remember the process is nothing but chloralkali. So that's, you take the brine solution and you pass electricity from the same. You get chlor, chlorine, alkali, NaOH with hydrogen gas also. They are pretty much interesting to know X and Y. What exactly is X here? Can you see the gas X? So this is my gas X, that's chlorine. And the compound Y, which is a bleaching agent. So this is your Y, calcium oxychloride. So isn't it super easy? My whole point to tell you is that when you focus on the important point like uses and all the salts that is there in the class 10th in this chapter, I don't think there must be any problem to solve such questions. Okay, take this as a priority. Okay, and students, if you really want to prepare for NTSC stage 2, you know that we have a special channel on Vedantu College, Vedantu Olympiad School. So you can prepare for NTSC stage 2. You can go and join that. There is a YouTube link also from 21st December to onwards. There are classes every Monday to Saturday with the best master teachers. You can prepare for stage 2 of NTSC. Don't miss this opportunity because that's great. Yes. Let's have this question. Question number 8. A metal carbonate X on react with an acid give a gas. Certain, like same kind of a question. That's metal carbonate. And that has to react with acid to give a gas, which when passed through the solution Y, give the carbonate back. So I'm going to have a gas which when react with the solution Y, give the carbonate back. A bit tricky question, but not at all difficult. If you try to remember, metal carbonate react with acid to give salt, water and CO2. So it's pretty obvious that the gas is CO2 along with water, and whatever that metal is, that's going to give any salt. Now they are telling what could be the Y that when react with the gas give the carbonate back. And if you remember, that's the biggest point to give you the main highlight, that my lime water, my calcium hydroxide aqueous solution, whenever react with CO2 gas gives us a metal carbonate, that's calcium carbonate. So can you get any clarity that what could be the metal carbonate? Yes, here we can prove out of the same, that's nothing but calcium carbonate. So a metal carbonate X, I detected the metal carbonate X, that's calcium carbonate. And acid, you can take anything. Suppose I took HCl, so I got calcium chloride, but that was not the purpose. They're not asking about the salt. Gas, that's Y, we detect the gas also. And now they're telling, on the other hand, a gas G that is obtained at anode during electrolysis of brine is passed on dry Y. Sorry, that was not Y, a solution Y. Y is this here. Okay, Y is this here. So they are telling that on the other hand, a gas G that is obtained at anode, when it's passed through calcium hydroxide, it gives a compound Z. And you remember that if I talk about this particular reaction, what could be that gas that's a product of my electrolysis of brine solution that react with calcium hydroxide. If you remember lime water, that's chlorine gas, hai na? To give calcium oxychloride, because it's proving also that is used for the disinfecting of the drinking water, and your bleaching powder is used for the same. So it gives a compound Z, we detect the compound Z or Z also, that's calcium oxychloride. And I hope you remember chlorine is the gas that we get on anode. Anode is something that attracts anion and attract chloride ion from the solution of the brine. That's NaCl, Cl negative ions were there. I'm repeating it again. My X is calcium carbonate, metal carbonate, when react with acid to give calcium chloride, salt, water and CO2 gas. How did we prove that? They are telling that the CO2 or whatsoever gas is there, whenever react with Y, give the carbonate back. And that's a very famous reaction of lime water with my CO2 that gives calcium carbonate. And that must be that calcium carbonate. Now, after that, there's one entire set of question again that this Y, whenever react with the gas that we get at anode of the process of chloralkali, react to give a substance Z or Z, which is used for the disinfecting of your drinking water. So that's nothing but your calcium oxychloride bleaching powder, and the gas was chlorine. So I think X, Y, G and Z or Z is all clear. A gas G, that is chlorine. Okay, this is my X, this is my Y, this is my G, and this is my Z or Z. Yeah, students? Entire solution is over there also, so you can revise it again. Okay, now let's move to the next question. It's easy peasy too. Came to year 2015. All right, let's solve this with me. Pretty easy, super easy if you remember. A white powder is used by doctors to support fractured bones. This is something that gave us the biggest hint, and we can't forget that. Write the name and chemical formula of the powder. So that white powder is nothing but our POP, because the name is giving the answer, plaster of Paris. Okay, and that plaster is my calcium sulfate dot half molecule of water. That's my calcium sulfate hemihydrate. That's my POP, plaster of Paris. So I told the name, I told the chemical formula. You can write the chemical name also. That's calcium sulfate hemihydrate. How's that prepared? Okay, that's interesting. Why we call it plaster of Paris? Because the main raw material is something that we get from the Paris from very starting, and that is calcium sulfate with two molecule of water. That is our gypsum. From gypsum, we got our POP. Okay, gypsum was heated at around 100 degrees Celsius. And when that was heated around 100 degrees Celsius, that's very tricky. Only half molecule is left in that. And 1.5, that means 3/2 water molecule is going to be evaporated. So this is your POP. That's how we got it, by heating gypsum around 100 degrees Celsius. Don't overheat it, because whole water molecule will be evaporated and you're left with calcium sulfate with no water molecule, called as dead burnt plaster. Not going to have that possibility to behave like a plaster and give a hard mass. Okay, that's what it is. Now the next question, that question can definitely come for 3 to 5 marks. When this white powder is mixed with the water, a hard solid mass is obtained. So it's like reversing the reaction, if you can see. So calcium sulfate again with half molecule of water, which is your POP, whenever mixed with water, every molecule will take 1.5, that means 3/2 molecule of water, to exactly give what? Calcium sulfate, 1/2 plus 3/2, 4/2, that is 2. That means with 2 molecule of water, that will give your gypsum back. So basically, when you use POP and you know apply it on the plaster, it gives the hard mass gypsum that is going to help to join the cracked bones. Okay, because it will remain still and won't move. Yeah, so that's what it is. Give one more use of this powder. Okay, that is very easy. You know that when it is the time of Durga Puja, Ganesh Puja and all, we use all the idols, and that's definitely made up of POP only. So the cast of statues is something that's made up of POP. Apart from that, the fall ceiling designs that we have in our home, that is also due to POP. And apart from that, when we go to laboratory, you know, we need sometimes airtight container for something, and to remove the air gap and to, you know, make it airtight, we use POP as well. So these are few of the aspects where we use it. You can let me know some more uses in the comment section. I'll wait for it. So I hope that's super duper clear. That's not at all difficult. Yes. Okay. That's so amazing. That's so amazing. Now we have one more question that came to the year 2013 and 17. Baking powder is used for baking a cake. We did talk about that. If your mother uses baking soda instead of baking powder in cake, how will it affect the taste? I told you that if you take directly baking soda, when you heat it, it's something that's going to give you washing soda along with CO2 gas that makes the cake soft and fluffy. But this is my basic substance washing soda, which makes the taste bitter of your cake and or whatsoever. You don't want to have a bitter cake. How can baking soda be converted to baking powder? So when you have your baking soda and mix with the edible acid like tartaric acid, you can have what? Baking powder. Why it is better? Because acid and kind of a basic substance will react to give a salt, a neutralized product, which is not going to affect the taste of the cake, because salt that is going to form is having a pleasant taste, like sodium tartarate along with water and CO2 gas. Yeah. So what's the role of tartaric acid added to baking soda? Definitely, I told you, tartaric acid will react with my baking soda and neutralize it and gives a salt, which is not going to affect the taste and having a pleasant taste. So that's the difference to use baking powder, not baking soda. I told you already, it's like a revision only. So I hope this is super duper clear too. And I hope whatever I told you is very much clear. And you know that how Vedanta is help to score, help to have a better score in your exam. So what do you all have to do? You can definitely go for all the quizzes. And how come you can be a part of all the quizzes? Just go for Vedanta courses and enroll for the same. Active learning will be there. Apart from that, you'll be able to compete with the students and live quizzes in the replay also. You'll be able to see. You can have all the content of Vedantu with the teacher's feedback with most important question, in-class doubt solving with the help of master teachers and a team of class teachers. Crash courses are going to start that you should not miss for your revision to boost your score right now. And for the same, you can enroll by applying the code AGEPRO, link in the description box, and can have the course for 2159 for a month with AGEPRO discount of 20%. And 5599, that means 1866 per month for 3 months course, and that's going to be very beneficial. So do let me know in case of any query. This is my Instagram handle. Vedantu is something that you'll see all the updates over there. I hope you like this session. I hope you'll make this video as a biggest hit also. And how will you do that? By passing it to your friends and all the groups, so that they can also see and tell them to pass it, so that this channel will become a big hit. And all the motivation of, you know, thinking more out of the box, we can have and can have such sessions as well. Don't forget to like the video. Let's have a target of 350 likes. Let's see, can we achieve that? And if you're new, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Thank you so much. I'll meet you next time. Until then, please take care of yourself. Have a safe year. Don't take the situation very light. I'll meet you next time. Tara, take care. Thank you.